My name is Annette Tamora, and I'm going to do my best to explain my story to you guys. Life is a journey filled with unexpected twists, challenges, and storms that threaten to shape the very foundation of our existence. This story is not a fairy tale with a magical resolution, but a testament to the resilience of an unwavering faith. Even amidst the painful realities of facing divorce and its aftermath. There's a new story of finding love, not in earthly realm, but on the profound embrace of God's guidance, courage, and the joy that transcends human understanding. From a young age, I felt a strong connection with the Holy Spirit. It happened during a visit to my aunt and uncle's church, my granny, where they spoke in tongues. I was a bit confused at first, but later on embraced the spiritual atmosphere. During my uncle's sermon, I got emotional and shed tears. This experience strengthened my sense of belonging to someone for something beyond the ordinary. Even though I couldn't fully understand it, I felt the genuine presence of the Father in my heart. In November, it was my 23rd wedding anniversary, marking the quarter century together. Our union blessed with the presence of four incredible children. It was a tapestry woven with threads of beauty and challenges that resonated with the reality of many families. From the start, we discovered that we were the opposites, a classic case of opposites attracting. I come from a small country town with a graduated class of less than 50 seniors. My roots are deeply tied to humble beginnings. On the other hand, my husband came from a more fluid background with a larger junior class and financial prosperity. This contrast, seemingly inconsequential at first, carried weight as our lives unfolded. Complicating matters, my husband and my family didn't quite see eye to eye. The tension heightened when my father's deep intuition perceived a lack of courtesy and not seeking permission for our relationship or asking for my hand in marriage. Even though my husband wanted to, my dad was just not having it at that point. The strained relationship between my husband and my family created challenging situations for me, caught in the middle of conflicting loyalties. Known for kindness and compassion, my efforts to understand others' feelings, I found myself at a breaking point. The continued strains on all kinds of issues took a toll, leading me to a moment where I could no longer extend the same level of understanding and empathy. The journey through these years has taught me that even in the face of significant differences, there is always room for growth, understanding, and rekindling of compassion. As I learned the art of cake decorating, my mom, who took Wilson's classes when I was a kid, inspired by her, my baking journey began with crafting sweet memories. Starting with my son, my son's first birthday, it was all about having fun and creating joy. Then life took an unexpected turn when my father received the devastating news, the three words no one wants to hear. You got cancer. In the face of my dad's five-year battle with cancer, I wanted to express gratitude to the doctors and nurses who were caring for him. So I baked cakes for them. Even in the summer setting of the cancer hospital, my cakes managed to bring smiles to people's faces. This led to me to be a profound realization. If I could bring happiness to others with something that brought me joy, why not turn that into a meaningful profession? My dad's journey taught me a profound lesson in kindness. Despite his struggles, he showed resilience and love for his grandkids, actively participating in medical studies to help others facing similar hardships. Witnessing his selflessness sparked a desire and need to focus on helping others. My focus of baking shifted from thank you gifts to spreading joy of all. After Valentine's Day, my husband suggested opening more bakeries, promising a lighter workload for me. I hesitated at the thought of working even harder, but we moved forward embarking on the journey of running 5 successful bakeries in 5 years. Amidst the busy bakery life and the loss of my dad, I found it challenging to take the time to properly read the exhaustion plan, and the pain wasn't easy. In my bakery, I introduced a special cupcake that was designed to raise awareness for all types of cancer. This cupcake became a symbol of hope, allowing those who were in mourning to celebrate milestones like the integration of chemotherapy or music promotion. This experience became a catalyst for change in my job, bringing a significant shift in its purpose. but that we stand here in the beginning. It's more than just, okay, making a way for people to be honored and celebrate their lives and long love to the past. As our health faces uncertainties, I encounter challenges that prompt a new business path for unification, love feeling detached. Simultaneously, my oldest turned 15, triggering unexpected emptiness. In search for purpose, my husband and I agreed to extend our family and I took a break from medication. Juggling multiple shots became overwhelming, and upon my return, bakery seemed different. But with the arrival of our third child, I felt a renewed determination. Despite challenges, I worked to turn the business around, but a job opportunity in Hawaii arose for my husband, and it brought new complexities. Hawaii's beauty brought me joy and a sense of God's presence, but despite the distance and challenges, my oldest son and my daughter during COVID, the gap widened between my husband and me. Encouraging him to pursue a job in California for personal growth and anticipated positive changes, however, the distance strained our relationship, leading to arguments and challenges for our children. As we approached the 1-year mark, the delay returned into the challenging reality. In the midst of despair, his eyes locked on her to return. I questioned, asking him, where is your hope? Do you not have faith to believe? His response, I live in the reality of what is happening. Reflected a stark contrast to a hopeful outlook. The grip of depression tightened, and I felt my decision, myself descending into a slippery slope. Each attempt to climb out seemed futile, describing this feeling as being in a dark hole. I sought to find help with my husband, but he was not in a place where he could provide what I was needing. The struggle intensified as daily responsibilities became overwhelming. I found myself crying more and more. Amidst these challenges, the presence of small children relying on me for essential care served in a stark contrast to the dark hole I found myself in. With the help of my mom, my brother, and my sister, they helped me let me know that they are there for support and eagerly reaching back to God. Yet, in the depths of despair, God intervened, revealing that I was still needed and capable of overcoming. Drawing near to church each Sunday became a source of renewed strength, allowing me to face challenges with the resilience that I did and I had. In my faith-strengthening journey, this church became my pillar during life's trials. The uplifting service in the local community provided a sense of belonging, located near my oldest son, that brought a newfound connection during life's struggles. Thrilled, I overcame distance barriers, and see, I live in love. Blessed to have my oldest son, his girlfriend, and now my daughter beside me, a sign of God working in mysterious ways. My spiritual roots deepened, anchoring me in God and faith. My youngest, my church, and my 3-year-old's upcoming baptism marks a symbolic step forward in my new journey. Despite lingering fears from hurtful words, solace came through prayer and deepened spiritual roots. The crucial verse saved me through relationship challenges. Be strong and courageous, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. This echoes the story of one walking on water shaped by God's right hand despite doubt. Life's waves rocked my paddleboard after moving. Leading to struggle, surrendering to God's guidance, I navigated challenges with strength for prayer and submission. Despite final financial hardships, God's hand provided solutions. Joy filled my heart as I rejoiced in each day given by God. Strength came from embracing His promises and the church community support. With my armor of faith, God, and the Holy Spirit, I faced anything. And during a visit from my husband, he questioned my abilities to even sustain myself. At church, there was a resonating song paired my experience. A storm of hurtful words raged, but I clung to God's truth. No longer afraid, I learned that God's words were my truth, unshakable. For those facing darkness, remember that with God's peace, love, and hope, you are equipped to handle it. I declare a connection that God's words were my truth, and no storm can break the firm foundation He provides. The journey through darkness becomes a testament to His peace, love, and hope that equip us facing anything. As we step back into our narratives, let us carry the torch of faith, knowing that we are not alone. But the helmet of salvation guarding our minds, the shield of faith protecting our hearts, and the sword of the Holy Spirit guiding our steps. The belt of the truth securing our foundation, we are more than conquerors. embrace the journey, through the embrace of God's unfailing love, we will find strength to navigate the storms and emerge in glorious light. As we part ways, remember, the tiny seed that we expect to be thrown into a dark hole, only to be covered by darkness and the heaviness of the soil, but then left to struggle and find its way out to the water and the light needed to help it grow. May this inspire you to persevere through darkness, knowing that the light of God's armor awaits you,